let's learn 6 different ways of summarizing PowerPoint presentations using Copilot. This feature is currently available only on the browser version. So I open any PowerPoint presentation. As soon as the presentation opens, it automatically summarizes the contents and gives you the summary as a pop-up. Click on this button to view the summary in the pop-up. If you want to interact with it, copy it, or continue the conversation further, you click on this button and now it will open in the Copilot pane on the right side. There's another presentation, 22 slides, and talks about key concepts of how to improve efficiency while working on Microsoft products. Now, I have noticed that in some presentations, the summary doesn't come up automatically, in which case you click on this button and then say summarize. And in this case, it will open directly on the right side pane. Remember, summary is just one way of understanding the presentation. Or I can ask it to give me the gist in few sentences. Other ways, only find action items from it. Now let's try a very large presentation. This one has 200 plus slides. Open this button and try summarize from here. Whenever you see this sign, it means there are subheadings there. It's showing it on expand collapse mode. Now I'm asking, what is the conclusion? And it gives me perfect output. Mind you, this is not a gist. This is a conclusion. There's a difference. Let's try one more use case. I'm asking it, what are the areas of improvement? Have I missed any topics? The Copilot has divided the suggestions into two categories: generic areas of improvement and specific topics. So there you have it. Different ways of summarizing PowerPoint presentations using Copilot. If you found this useful, share it with as many people as you can. And I also need to know whether you're finding it useful. So subscribe, like the video, and give me more feedback. That's it for now. See you soon. Thank you.